Good morning, students. I welcome you once again. In our last class, I told you about the sentence. Today, I am going to tell you about the sentence, the phrase, and the clause. Now, look at the sentence. Sentence number one. I met a boy in the garden. Second sentence. A stone was thrown into the river. Third sentence. She is cooking food in the kitchen. Fourth sentence. He does his work very carelessly. Fifth sentence, that house is very beautiful. Now, I want you to think the first sentence as a sentence. As I told you, a sentence start with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Between those two is a sentence, complete sentence. I met a boy in the garden is a complete sentence. Now, look at the underlined words, in the garden. The three words are underlined and they make a group. In the second sentence, into the river. Again, there are three words and they are making a group. Likewise, in third sentence, the kitchen. This is a group of two words. In the fourth sentence, we have two words underlined very carelessly. These two words again are a group. That house is very beautiful. Very beautiful. This group is underlined and it has two words. Now, at a time you have a sentence in front of you and then you find some words underlined. About a sentence you know well, what are these underlined words? Could you tell me? A sentence is made of words and some words come in a group. The words that come in a group are called phrases, shabd-samuh. So, what kind of phrases are these? I am going to tell you about these. And what a clause is? First of all, I must tell you about a phrase. A phrase is a group of words, as you have seen. It is a related group of words. They are related with each other and they are related in such a way that they create some meaning. Meaning that is a part of a greater meaning, or let me say a complete meaning. A meaning that is a part of a complete meaning. So that phrase, that group of words do have meaning, but not complete meaning. दीज वर्ड्स वर्क टुगेदर एज ए यूनिट बट दे डू नॉट हैव ए सब्जेक्ट एंड ए वर्ब. सो इट मस्ट बी क्लियर दैट ए फ्रेज इज ए ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, ए ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड इट डज नॉट हैव ए सब्जेक्ट एंड ए वर्ब. द वर्ड्स इन दैट पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप एक्ट एज ए यूनिट, दे मेक ए मीनिंग बट नॉट ए कंप्लीट मीनिंग दैट ए सेंटेंस प्रोड्यूसेस. द फ्रेज गिव्स ए पार्शियल मीनिंग. आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द फ्रेज इन डिटेल इन कमिंग videos, coming sessions. So for time being, let's move further about on the clause, what a clause is. A clause is a group of words that does have both a subject and a verb. Students, just see, a sentence is a group of words, the phrase is a group of words, and the clause is again a group of words. A sentence has a complete meaning, it has a subject and verb, but the phrase doesn't have a subject and a verb and doesn't have a complete meaning. Now look at the clause. The clause has a subject and a verb, like a sentence. A sentence is always a clause, but a clause is not always a sentence. Some clauses are independent, meaning that they express a complete thought. When a clause expresses a complete thought, then that clause is a independent clause and that is a complete sentence. But sometimes some clauses are dependent, meaning that they cannot stand alone. They do have a subject and a verb, but they do not express a complete thought. Dependent clauses are called subordinate clauses. The clauses that are dependent, they have their meaning in relation with the independent clause. Wherever there is a dependent clause, the sentence of which they are part, that is a complex type of sentence. We will talk about the clause in succeeding videos, lectures and sessions. It was our introductory class about the phrase, the clause and the sentence. The clause is of two types, independent clause and dependent clause. Dependent clause is also called subordinate clause. Dependent or subordinate clause are of three kinds. A dependent clause is either a relative clause, either noun clause, or an adverb clause. We will study about these clause in detail in upcoming sessions. We have different kind of phrases: noun phrase, verb phrase, prepositional phrase, adverb phrase, adjective phrase, टू इन्फिनिटिव फ्रेज, जिरेंडल फ्रेज, पार्टिसिपल फ्रेज एट्सेट्रा. इन अपकमिंग सेशंस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट दीज टॉपिक्स फॉर टुडे.